Everyone, welcome back. The previous video, we were setting up the options menu. We ran into a little bit of a problem. I couldn't figure out why it was doing what it was doing in the previous video, so let's recap real quick. So if we go to options, whoops, not if we go to options. Let's start from afresh. Show an explorer. Save games, let's delete this. So when we play, please set up your player profile. I enter a name, I choose an avatar, I hit accept, go into options, it's there, but as soon as I change this and hit something else and I hit accept and I go back in there, and then I go to quit, and then I play, options, it says please set up your player profile again to continue. There's one thing that we forgot to do, so let's fix this. I figured out what it was something super small. So to fix this, we're going to need to go to the blueprints and all levels in our game info instance, actually. Let's open that up. And inside of here, for the section for showing the option menu, we need to run a quick check. So we've created, checking to see if we've created a save file. So at the end, after you've added it to viewport, let's hold B and left click, create a branch. Connect this up. Take our created save file. Drag that on top, like so. And let's take our options menu, copy that, paste it. And we can drag off of this and we can say set welcome message vis. And we'll set it to visible. And we're going to set it off the false. So we've determined that there is not a save file. Then we're going to set it to visible. So I'm just going to extend that out actually a little bit. Let's compile and save. Close that out. Let's go back to the options menu now. So the options menu widget blueprint. Inside of it, the welcome message visibility. Go ahead and set that to hidden by default. I know I had set it to visible in the previous video, but set that to hidden. And the other thing I noticed, inside the save game check function, we created these two booleans at the end that we don't even use. So I'm going to delete those. The reason we did that is we were going to use it here as part of our accept, but we're setting that value inside of our game instances set instead. So we don't even need this variable. I'm going to delete that. So let's compile and save. And let's start fresh. So let's right click, show an explorer, go to the content, saved, save games. Let's delete this. So now if we play, please set up your player profile. We'll say cool guy. And he's using that because that looks cool. Go into options. That is there. Escape options. We could change it again to Mr. Nice Guy. And that looks funky. So let's accept that. Options. Back. Quit. Play. Shouldn't see the message. We should go into options. Shouldn't see it up here. So it looks like we fixed it now. Just a minor thing that I thought we did, but we didn't. So we fixed it. Okay, our options, player options are set. What we'll do in this video now is set up the find a match. So from the main menu, when we click find a match, our main menu is just about done. When we click find a match here, it'll pop up a different menu for us. Then we'll probably pause. This will be a short video because the next video will be a little bit longer because we're going to do all the script for what happens in finding a match. So let's go to the UI main menu, server menu, and let's dock that up top. Let's go to the options menu on the designer and copy the border here. So we'll take this border, copy it, and you know what, actually let's not do the options, let's do the host menu because it's going to have better setup for us. It's actually both of these are what we're going to be using, so this is going to be an easier one to start from. So let's copy this, copy that border. Let's close that out, close this, and let's go to our server menu and paste it. And let's move that over here. So for this is not going to be a host game setup, so let's change this, and we'll change this to find a match, something like so. Let's move this over just a little bit more. again, right now, being able to search by server name and all that is not publicly exposed through Blueprint. Maybe down the road, that's something that will get implemented, and where we can search by server name, we could search by game mode if we wanted, et cetera. So our find a match menu is going to be very, very simple, actually. We're going to take our enter server name. We're going to delete that. Don't need that. We don't need to enter a name, so we don't need that. Number of players, don't need that. Don't need this. That's literally all we need, is the choose play method and whether or not we're searching for LAN or internet play. There's a couple other things that we're going to add to this to kind of give it a little bit better of a look here. So it's going to collapse this and collapse this. So this section here, we're going to right click on this. We're going to wrap that with a widget switcher. See why in a second. So we have a widget switcher. I'm actually going to name this horizontal box play mode. And then what we'll do is go up to the palette. We'll grab a circular throbber under primitive, drag and drop that on top of the widget switcher, like so. And we'll hit F2 on this. We'll call this loading. And we'll make some changes to that because that thing is super tiny. We'll go over in the details panel. We'll bump the number of pieces up to say something like 8. We'll bump the radius up to something like 44. Feel free to change these as you'd like. And then the other thing that we'll do, we'll add some text. So let's go up here, take some text, drag and drop that on top of the widget switcher. And let's hit F2 on this, and we'll call this countdown. Countdown. So. And countdown, all countdown is going to be as a number, so let's just say 10 to start. So what's going to happen is when we get to this menu, we're going to present the user with choosing the play method, where they can choose to search for local games or internet games via Steam. With these options, they'll click accept. It will then switch to a loading screen. These two options will go away, and this will say searching. Once it's done and it finds a match, it will then present the user with a message that says match found, would you like to join, and begin a countdown from 10 seconds down to 0, where they can accept to join or decline it. Once it reaches 0, it will return back to this, where you can research if you'd like, or you can cancel out at any point, decline it, like I said, to return back to this as well. We're doing it this way. The older method of having a server list where you can see all the available servers and pick which one you want to join was the way that I originally set this project up, but I wanted to do something a little bit different, do it similar to what Paragon's doing, actually. This is the way that Paragon does it. I'm sure they do things a little bit differently, but essentially you choose to find a match. It starts searching for a match for you. It presents you with that option of joining the match, at which point you can accept or decline. And that's the way that we are going to set it up here as well. If you'd like to see the other way of having a server list of all the servers that you could potentially join, the multiplayer shootout project, I believe, does it this way. The other reason I didn't do it this way is because we cannot assign our server name as part of the Blueprint session result. It actually takes your computer name, or it takes your Steam name and uses that if you're connected to Steam. So there's no way to set that through Blueprint currently. You could probably do it through code, but this being a Blueprint only project, didn't want to go down that route. So long story short, this is why we are doing it this way, which it should work just fine, as you saw in the overview video. So having said all of that, we're going to pause here because this is a short video. We're going to pick it up in the next video, where we start working on the graph portion of actually searching for games, presenting users with the found search and the ability to join. So we're going to pause here. We'll pick it back up in the next video, where we start working on the graph.